This is an update of an earlier video about which is a better rootstock, Pereskiopsis or Opuntia. We have grafted moon cactus to these two rootstocks. Why? Because these two rootstocks are so popular in the internet and we would like to find out which one really works. If you haven't watched the first video, please click this link or click the thumbnail at the end of this video. After 3 weeks, here's the moon cactus grafted to an Opuntia elata. Looks good. After 3 weeks, here's the moon cactus grafted to a Pereskiopsis. Looks good too. And there's a shoot on the side. Normally, I let it grow for about an inch so I can pat it and don't waste it. After 2 months, here's the moon cactus grafted to an Opuntia. It started to die. The reasons could be a failure of graft or mismatch of scion and rootstock. Either way, a moon cactus grafted to an Opuntia will fail soon. After 2 months, here's the moon cactus grafted to a Pereskiopsis. Still looking good. I even have another video with a moon cactus grafted to a Pereskiopsis and still growing after 9 months. When this video is done, I will add the thumbnail at the end of this video. Choosing between these two rootstocks, which are so popular in the internet, is clear. Choose Pereskiopsis. It's easy to graft using it. You can graft the small moon cactus. No need to tie the scion to the rootstock, and the graft survives for a long time. Which of these popular rootstocks would you like to try? Opuntia or Pereskiopsis? Please leave your comments below and don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Happy succulents gardening!